Assalamu alaikum students, in this lab experiment we are going to calculate the energy loss in a hydraulic jump. The objective of this lab experiment is to compare the experimental value of depth before a hydraulic jump to that calculated from the theory and to calculate the energy loss in a hydraulic jump. For this lab experiment we need open channel flume, scale and a notebook. Okay, the formation of hydraulic jump is associated with a sudden rise in the depth of water and it involves the turbulence and a lot of energy dissipation. So basically it implied at the foot of spillways and other hydraulic structures which are used for the purpose to dissipate the energy. So through this lab experiment, students will be able to understand the features of hydraulic jump and they will be able to estimate the energy loss in the hydraulic jump. So now let's discuss about the theory of this lab experiment. For this lab experiment we need to estimate the specific discharge. Specific discharge is basically discharge per unit width of the channel. So here we can easily see the relationship of discharge with upstream and downstream depths. If we have the specific discharge and the value of upstream depth, from these two values we can easily estimate the downstream depth. So in the first equation, y1 is the depth before the jump, y2 is the depth after the jump. Small q is the discharge per unit width of the flume or the specific discharge, and where g is the gravitational acceleration. And finally, the energy loss equation is totally depends upon the upstream and downstream depths. If we have the values of upstream and downstream, then we can easily estimate the energy loss. So the procedure is as follows. First of all, you have to start the pump and then you have to adjust the flow rate in the flume. You can also adjust the flow rate by using the sluice gate and also the valves. Raise the adjustable veer or sluice gate to form a hydraulic jump. Then you have to note the depth before the jump and after the jump. And you can also estimate the opening of the sluice gate. And you have to create the hydraulic jump on different values of discharge. So students, you already know how to develop a hydraulic jump in the flume, as I already have developed the jump in the flume. And you have to just estimate the depths in the upstream and downstream flows. And after that you can easily use these two values to estimate the energy loss. But before estimating the energy loss, you have to find out the value of specific discharge. And then after estimating the value of specific discharge, you have to calculate the value of y2 by using the equation of specific discharge.